gracious good day to one and all once again. Tis I, Norton the First, by grace of God, Emperor of the United States and Protector of Mexico, joined every Saturday, as we always are, by our special guest superstar, the Countess Lola Montez of Lansfeld. Good day, Countess.
Good day, Your Majesty, and good day to all of you here. It's a very foggy morning.
It is indeed. Yes. And this is episode number 114 of Emperor Norton's fantastic history vlog. Today is August 8th, 2020. It is our 144th day under COVID-19 restrictions.
Thank you so much for joining us today. And you know, the fog is such a part of San Francisco. And today we're going to talk about one of my heroes of the Beat generation, the Beat goddess, Ruth Weiss.
Oh, yes.
Now, did you know, Your Majesty, that when Ruth Weiss was a young lady and she was in New Orleans, she heard about the fog of San Francisco and said she must come here to see it? Well, we have our fog, don't we?
We do indeed. Mm-hmm. It's even inside today.
Amazing that. Right. How about that, huh? But I want to say this, that, you know, there was a fella, a lot of times, let's clear this up right now as the fog clears. Mm-hmm. The coldest winter I ever spent was a summer in San Francisco. Hmm. And many attribute that, do they not, to Samuel Clemens, Mark Twain.
Yes, Clemens.
Well, that's a falsehood, is it not?
It is indeed. No one knows who actually said it, and there's no documentation of him saying it or writing it. It's true, but there's no documentation as to who said it.
That's true. That's true. We do not write history. History writes itself. Correct?
Yes.
Yes, indeed. So, do you like poetry?
Oh, yes. It's one of my favorite things in the world.
Yes. Well, a lot of folks do enjoy poetry. And I know some of you have asked about it. And I love to have my rhymes and limericks. But, you know how a poet sneezes, right?
No.
Haiku! Yes. Why are poets so poor?
I have no idea.
Because rhyme doesn't pay. Where do poems come from?
Where's that?
Po-trees. Where do poets obtain poetic licenses?
I don't know, but I need to get mine renewed.
From the DMV, the Department of Metrical Verse. Why did the traffic cop give the poet a ticket?
I don't know.
For driving without a poetic license.
Has to get it renewed.
Why was John Keats always hounded by creditors?
I don't know.
Because he owed so much. Well, I want you to know, I don't consider myself a real poet, but I did write one.
Oh, you did?
Would you like to hear it, Your Majesty?
Absolutely.
Yes. Birdie, birdie in the tree. Birdie, birdie in the sky. Drop some white stuff in my eye. I'm a big girl, I won't cry. I'm just glad that cows don't fly. But on a serious note, if you have never read the poetry of Ruth Weiss, here's a good example of a collection of hers and things about Ruth Weiss wrote Light and other poems, and this particular book for these women of the Beat. Now, in a time of Jack Kerouac and many of the others of the Beat generation, Allen Ginsberg and such. She was one of the few women that came about. And Ruth Weiss, the Beat goddess, passed away, unfortunately, July 31st. She was 92 years old.
Wow.
Rest in peace.
Indeed.
Yes. Now, we will remember her for her contributions of the Beat generation and to the culture of North Beach and the poetry scene. Born Jewish in Europe during the rise of Nazism, she was a 10-year-old refugee and escaped to the United States with her family. Ruth Weiss was born in Berlin, Germany, June 24th, 1928. She spent her childhood exploring nature, reading and writing. When she was 4 years old, she received a Brothers Grimm fairy tale book from her parents. And in 1939, she and her family came to New York, then moved to Chicago, Illinois. Well, now, I must tell you, I hope you can all see me through the fog. Well, what happened is she excelled academically at school in Chicago and graduated at the top 1% of her class. However, in 1946, the war was over and her family moved back to Germany. This time, not as German citizens, but as American citizens. And as her parents worked for the Army of Occupation in the 1960s, Ruth changed the spelling of her name to the lowercase as a protest of the law and order ethos of her birthplace in Germany, where nouns are all capitalized.
Indeed.
Now, she went on to school in Switzerland and spent much of her time hitchhiking and writing. And in 1948, Ruth and her parents moved back to the United States, resettling in Chicago. Now, in 1949, she left home, at first staying in Chicago, where she moved into the Art Circle, a housing community for artists. And it was there she began experimenting with poetry and jazz. In 1950, she left Chicago and hitchhiked to Greenwich Village, New York. Then later that year, hitchhiked to New Orleans, living in the French Quarter.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you know, when she was in Chicago, one of the many poets that she rubbed elbows with is one of my favorites, is Gwendolyn Brooks.
Oh, yes.
Yes, who actually tutored Ruth a bit. Yes, and one of the amazing things I learned about Ruth, too, is she learned English just by listening to people.
Hmm.
You know, we can do that. Some of us are tone deaf, but you know, if you listen to people, you can really figure out a language sometimes with the way things are emphasized and all that. And she spoke, German was her first language.
Mm.
Now, in 1952, she had heard about the fog of San Francisco, which we have here.
Yes, indeed.
And she wanted to see it. And she'd heard so many things about San Francisco. So she hitchhiked out here and moved here. And this is where she began jamming and reading poetry with street musicians. Shortly after, a few of her friends opened a club called The Cellar, in which she would hold poetry and jazz sessions every Wednesday.
Hmm.
Eventually, Ruth Weiss felt she needed a break from the city and city life and took off for California's Big Sur, and a place made famous as a beat center due to Jack Kerouac's novel of the same name. Now, Ruth began publishing in the magazine Beatitude, one of the first magazines for beat writers. In 1952, Ruth met Jack Kerouac, Neil Cassady. In her own words, they had a fantastic connection on multiple levels. Well, Weiss and Kerouac engaged in haiku dialogue, spending hours over a bottle of wine, writing haiku back and forth to each other. And in 1957, Ruth started a salon kind of situation in her apartment.
Mm.
She created a gathering space for poets and writers to read and to discuss their works. In 1959, she published her poetry collection, Gallery of Women, paying homage to the female poets, whom she most admired by painting their portraits through her jazz-inspired poetry. In 1961, she finished her narrative poem, The Brink. Upon reviewing her poem, the painter Paul Beadle asked if Weiss could turn it into a film script, which she did. And later, Ruth Weiss described her work of Desert Journal as her masterpiece and a most significant work. She began writing the poem in 1961 and would spend 7 years on it, not completing it until 1968. But it was published in 1977. She was married to an artist, Paul Blake, for 41 years. They had no children. Ruth said in the documentary, Ruth Weiss, the Beat Goddess, and by the way, if you get a chance, see that film because it's lovely there, yes. And she said in the documentary that her poems are her children and will continue on her line. Ruth Weiss won many, many awards, and she has written so many things, I dare not start listing them. We'll still be doing this next week. But was also known for her longtime environmental activism, often writing about the plight of whales and redwood trees. And in 2020, Ruth Weiss would attend the Women's Day March on March 8th. For the last time, that, and she read, Ruth Weiss was awarded the CinemaQuest Film Festival Maverick Spirit Award. And on July 31st, 2020, in Albion, California, in her home, where she lived in the Redwoods, Ruth Weiss died at the age of 92. To quote Ruth Weiss, "There is no such thing as an end. I believe in the spiral that keeps on going." Ruth Weiss, the Beat Goddess, rest in peace. And thank you all for your gifts and inspiration, Ruth. Indeed.
Well, thank you, Candace. That was lovely.
Well, I have a special treat today, too, share with our guest.
Oh, how wonderful.
And please, you know, if you have a memory of Ruth Weiss, please leave comments down below and let us know. Yeah, I love those stories of her. She was quite the character. Now, today we're going to do a little magic, Your Majesty.
Oh, boy.
Yes. And I will introduce our special guest. Have you ever heard of Luda Kazell?
No, that name does not ring a bell.
Well, I thought since we were celebrating the life of Ruth Weiss, that I would conjure her back from the time, not Ruth Weiss, but I would conjure back Luda Kazell from the Yiddish Theater of Warsaw, Poland. She was a renowned star and has become a world sensation in her lifetime internationally. Luda has been one of the biggest, brightest stars of Yiddish theater. Now, Yiddish cabaret was quite the rage in the late 20s and early 30s. Mm-hmm. And maybe, perhaps, you've seen many different versions of things happening back in those days. Christopher Isherwood made a trip to Berlin and, you know, wrote about it. He was English, he was not Jewish, but he wrote about the cabaret scene, and that turned into the musical Cabaret with Liza Minnelli that we all know. But Luda Kazell was in a hit called Sweet Moments, written by Louis Freeman and William Siegel. But she was famous for one of those heart-rendering songs of Mir Welt, O Freund, written by Isidore Lillian and Sholem Segunda. And it's, to translate Mir Welt, O Freund, I need a friend. Mm. Now, we should conjure her back.
Oh, yes.
And perhaps she will sing a more current English version song.
I can't wait.
Yes. So, for the first time, as per request, we bring her today to sing for us. The first time in English, I might add. And I'm going to conjure her now. And ladies and gentlemen, and all that possess a beating heart, the amazing romantic Ludicozelle, hocus pocus, let's all focus on a Yiddish maidel and hostess mostess. Ludicozelle.
Halten lieben is kringle of machen lieben. It's easier to observe life than to make a life. Stars shining bright above you. Night breezes seem to whisper, I love you. Birds singing in the sycamore tree. Dream a little dream of me. Say nighty night and kiss me. Just hold me tight and tell me you miss me. While I'm alone and blue as can be, dream a little dream of me. Stars fading, but I linger on, dear, still craving your kiss. I'm longing to linger till dawn, dear, just saying this. Sweet dreams till sunbeams find you. Sweet dreams that leave all worries behind you. And while in your dreams, dream a little dream of me. La na na. Dream a little dream of me. Starts fading, but I linger on, dear, still craving your kiss. I'm longing to linger till dawn, dear, just saying this. Sweet dreams till sunbeams find you. Sweet dreams that leave all worries behind you. But in your dreams, whatever they be, dream a little dream of me.
Times, eh? History indeed. Well, I hope you've enjoyed today's show and thank you for tuning in. A special thanks going out to all of the community of San Francisco history. Stay safe, sheltering in place, And I would suggest, Your Majesty, that if people want to know more about Ruth Weiss and her wondrous works, you can Google on the YouTube Ruth Weiss, the Beat Goddess, and look up things about her. Also, you can find the Impronion. You're still doing shows every day.
Yes, we do this show Tuesday through Saturday, Tuesday through Friday, just Your Emperor. And then on Saturdays, we bring in our superstar, the Countess Lola Montez. Also, don't forget to leave your comments below. We really like the comments. Also, we are accepting tips. There are expenses incurred with doing this vlog. So here's the information for that. If you want to do a subscription, a monthly donation, you can do that via Patreon. Or you could make a one-time donation via PayPal, and we appreciate all of our wonderful donors. If you'd like more information about what the Countess and I do, here's the information right there for our websites. So that wraps it up for today's edition. Until we meet again, stay safe, stay inside, stay healthy. If you do go outside, wear a damn mask.
Ever in service and gratitude, au revoir.
And be kind to one another. Don't take unproven cures. Until we see you again, a gracious good day.